So every day we go to work and we are all immersed in design. We open our laptops and we see a user experience. We are busy with our wireframes. But there's a lot more that we all know that goes beyond a user experience or the wireframe that we are creating. You look at the left, you go right, and there's so many design problems to solve. So I'm going to take this moment today to really give you a window that there is possibility of us as designers to go beyond the user experience of a UI and create a much more larger ecosystem of design and influence it as a true designer. I'll take a moment to go back. In about 2005, that's when we kind of started and seeded huge designs, and we thought that what is the kind of a demand that this country has? And I'm going to, all my talk is going to be around what's happening in this country. So in about 2005, not much demand for UX. Rather, user interface was probably limited to desktops. Okay, but as we moved forward, a lot more iPhone things happened and tablets happened, and suddenly the industry started becoming much more sensitive towards user experience design. And so the demand went up. But the supply of talent was still at its nascent stage. Maybe IITs and NIDs had design courses, but that's about it. But today, the landscape is completely different. We have good demand for user experience, and we have good talent coming in as well, thanks to all these design institutes that are coming up. And they are gearing up for these things. So far, the market has really grown up. So it's nice, good news for all of us designers. The market is becoming sensitive to design. We are helping them make more better user interfaces. Talent design schools are growing, education is growing. And as a good synergy between the two, the design talent and the design and the companies and the industry, all of us are gearing up with setting up departments, making much more effort, concrete effort to make design a good practice. So that's a good thing. And that's where the growth is, and it's going up and up. This is how a design looked in about 2010. And this is not a wireframe. This is still a user interface that goes out live. But today, if you see, it's much more colorful. The practice has become more sensitive. Typography, color schemes, understanding the users and whatnot. So user experience professionals have now started to talk to design heads, the business heads, and understand what really the user needs. Started creating user personas, becoming much more sensitive to good-looking wireframes and deliverables, looking at what is the usability of page-level usability, page flows usability, and working in conjunction with developers and product managers and so on and so forth. So what we have achieved so far is that my work, my efforts are now creating some return on investment for the businesses because of the work that I'm doing on the user interfaces. But here is what the report says, and this is what we, when we are running huge designs and we are working with industry, we know that companies are still struggling to make big design decisions and make big design impact. What we are ending up doing is tweaking some features and functions here and there and making very minimalistic efforts. You're on the phone, excuse me, please. You're on the phone, if you could take the phone from outside. So not much meaningful design impact. Another report says, economies are growing. We're all seeing it, right? We are seeing a lot of startups. People are investing a lot of money. But according to this report, not much companies are willing to take risks and make much more innovation in the market. When there is actually a need, when the economies are growing, buying power is in the hands of the customer, why are companies not really raising to the occasion? Three things that still need to be done. Customer needs, of course, all of us know, as customers, we always struggle with companies, and they are not able to really meet the needs that we have. Processes are longer, right? We order online, but the courier fellow doesn't come. When he comes, he's going to the wrong address and whatnot. So a lot of process issues as well. and lack of innovation. We always feel, oh, there could be a lot more that companies could do for the end users. So a lot of competition happening around the world, around all of us, and then there is a struggle that people are going through in terms of expectations. So this report says that a lot more, maybe it's a CEO or a CTO or a business owner or even us as designers in the executive chair are not moving forward as much as we need to make a bigger design impact for ourselves, to make profits, businesses, as well as giving back to the users. So when I was looking through all of these reports, this was the question that came to my mind. Should I be feeling sad that I'm just making not so meaningful impact on by just building features and functions and delivering and going home? Or is there an opportunity for me to really showcase who really I am, not just the user experience for user interfaces, but much more longer and wider impact that I could do as a designer? And so another report, which also was encouraging, that at the end of the day, businesses would make money only when the customer is happy. And to make customer happy, who else can do a better job than us as designers? Another report, value will come through design thinking. Okay, so good opportunity for all of us. So now let's see, what does this really mean for all of us? Today, so businesses have a lot of ideas. They will say, hey, I have a function to add. I have a feature to add. Let's bake that in. So they go and talk to the technologists. And technology would say, oh, I have a platform. We could plug this chatbot here and another function or a feature here. So they would do some platform work and then go to the designers and say, hey, you know what? Can you design me a nice bot and maybe a chat window? And you end up implementing that and end of the story. But imagine the width that I was talking about is you are focusing on that mobile app or the desktop app icon that you see there, but when you're designing an ecosystem for, let's say, a hospital, this map is a ecosystem of a hospital. There's a patient coming in and he's calling in, then there's an ambulance touch point, and there are family members who are taking care of the patient, and then there is a recycle plant. So there are a lot more things that make things happen to make a hospital run successfully. And everywhere, there is an experience involved. There is a designer required to make sure that the system really works well. So can we go beyond that mobile app design and desktop app design? Of course, yes. There are a lot of these workshops that we have seen where we are learning what are the different touch points of the user and how they could make the user's life successful. So as designers, we have learned that. Now it's time for us to take action and develop it. So in the subsequent slides, I'm going to talk about what are the possible areas and how we could do and start moving from user experience for user interfaces and start having a larger impact, and we have the capability to do that. So role of designers, find faults, right? We love finding faults, and that comes naturally to us. There's nothing bad about it. When we look at any systems, we start seeing that, hey, this is broken down, and this experience is not really well. And if we find real big problems, and that is what businesses are interested in. So as designers, we need to be very sensitive when someone is asking you to plug in a feature, put in an icon, change the color of the background. Think you are not making a larger design impact. You're just putting a small time in a particular day and going home. Is there an opportunity we can start looking at a much bigger level? In order to do that, of course, we see that we struggle, right? We struggle in terms of, oh, can I do this? I have this icon to fix, I'll create that icon, I'll create this user interface, and I'll go home. How can I move big mountains? Here is an answer. There is a school of thought that designers, business owners, and technologists could come together as one team and make larger impact. So here is a design team, and then there is the businesses, and then there are developers or technologists. Imagine the design team, one person from the design team comes and collaborates with the business unit head and says, hey, let's talk about some of the problems that we have at hand for a product that we have or the company or the service that we are here providing for the users. Or let's say a design team member and a developer comes together and he becomes a creative technologist or a design engineer. And these, some of these new titles have started coming, emerging into the market. So today the inhibitions that designers have that, hey, I have everything in my mind, I know there are a lot of problems, but how do I communicate it? Good, now you have team members. You can talk to the business unit head who is now becoming part of your ambition to change the world or the ecosystem and the product that you're designing, and tell a business story together. You tell certain part of the story in terms of user, and the business person who's joined you, collaborating with you, could talk the business impact of it. By that, you are learning something about business, and the business has now started to learn something about design. So design knowledge is spreading. So something that was always looked upon, oh, the design department will do this. Instead of that, now you are taking one step and started to collaborate with a lot more people, and the virus would now meaningfully spread. They will start talking your design language. Something that will probably help us on the way is ability to make judgment and decisions. Now you're not solely relying on your own mind to take decisions and make design or decisions, but you have team members now to talk about it. So what does this really mean? So this is what you're doing. We are doing user interfaces, maybe another few other systems like a mobile app or a desktop app or an admin app and whatnot. So these are supporting product systems. Maybe there are some services. Maybe there's an email that goes to the customer, so I'll go ahead and redesign that email. But there are a lot of processes that are involved in getting, moving your product out to the users. And there are structures, right? If let's imagine that you have a Book My Show app, there is a structure that runs behind to make Book My Show make good design impact on the users. Example, there is a person who stands at the movie gate and scans your QR code, right? So that's also a structure. That's also design. Book My Show, to become extremely successful, also has to make sure that the structure of the people, structure of the infrastructure is in place to make the entire design successful. So it's beyond user interface that the designer is playing a lot more larger role to make a meaningful impact on the end user. And so are the channels. Like a food delivery app, channel could be drone tomorrow. Today, the guy comes on the bike, on Swiggy bike, and delivers the food to you, but tomorrow it could be something else. Channels are changing by the day. And brand, all these things that we all do has an impact on the brand. So there's an area for us designers to have an impact on the brand. And then there is network. Businesses today don't rely and courier the product themselves or send transactions. They always collaborate with micro companies. Now, as designers, you have to understand that impact of that network as well. And then the last thing, which is we all know that customer experience or customer engagement is also an important piece of it. And all of these things we do just to make profits. When profits happen, the money comes into the company. The money coming into the company is then going to go into your pocket. So there is a direct impact. The work, the design impact that you do will make more money for the businesses. That means everyone is getting rich. So I'm calling this as design of things. These are the 10 areas that I have been identified as the areas for innovation. So if these are the only 10 areas in any product or service that are being identified as areas of influence for innovation, that's where designers need to be. So if you could take a look at this and say, hey, oh, I was doing product design, the usable functions and features, oh, but there's a lot more things for me to do. So what do I do? So maybe I'm a designer, but I come from economics background. Can I play some role in the business? Maybe I am good at people and social skills, so maybe I can work on some of the structures. So maybe let's take an example of a food delivery app and look at this aspect. So let's say there is a process. There's a standard operating procedures for delivery of the food. Or let's say there is a store experience in the channel. or let's say there's a brand building or a personality that needs to be developed for my brand if I'm working for a food delivery company, or a structure, right? Resources and infrastructure needs to be built. Who's going to do that? There are people who are doing it, but we all know that the design sense in all of these silos is still broken. Great opportunity for us as design thinkers and influence the entire thing. And when we are doing that, now we will not be called as, oh, come here, do the user interface for me. They will be saying, hey, let's strategize and make a bigger design impact and business impact. Seems very overwhelming, but so then I said, okay, let me see and try to put some structure in which this can be achieved. So typically the design attitude, oh, let's start creating, right? So you take a paper or pencil, brainstorm, and try to deliver or create something, but that's not it. There could be a structured approach to how you could do this. Get the facts, look at, so you may choose a process, you may choose a channel, or any of those four things that we saw as an example. Start collaborating with these people. Get to the bottom of the facts as to how the current system works. Then look at what are the current touch points, what are the problems with the current touch points. And then look at, oh, according to me as a designer, and while I'm collaborating with the subject matter expert or the technology expert or the business unit head for that particular silo, what could be the new path? What would work for the business in terms of making money? From a user experience point of view, what it could be? And what could really work for the technologist also? And then go ahead and make certain alternatives. Question those alternatives. Now collaboratively, you're questioning each other's moves. You are questioning the business stand. You are questioning the technology stand. And let them also question the design stand. But homogeneously, you're taking a collective opportunity. And then overall evaluate it and take a stand and present it to the management. Now this way, you are making a far more outreach. Rather than people coming to you, you are going to the people and really showing the value of design. How could you do this? I was contemplating on how while you are at work and you have your daily deliverables, you could follow the philosophy of Skunkworks. If you don't know what Skunkworks is, look up, Google it up. It was a time when you had to innovate but had to keep it under the wraps. During the World War, when in the United States, they had to create bombers without letting anyone know. They went into the hiding, got people together from different domains and created an expert showcase of what new innovation could be. So something like this, you could get inspired and say, okay, you know what? I feel very passionate about a certain aspect in my product, in my service that I'm providing, and I need to do something about it. Let me get that SME. Let me get that product owner or the business unit head. Get them into the room and collaborate and come up with something which is far more better and not so broken as it is today. So what are some of the qualities that you could have or imbibe in the people whom you're going to work? So one of the qualities that you always need to have and also probably motivate others to do is become a strong inquirer. Start inquiring into everything that you see. It's easy to say, hey, this is broken and that is broken, but start inquiring as to why it is broken and what does it mean. Start thinking, obviously, communicate. Designers usually have a lot of thoughts and ideas, but fail to communicate. So see how you could learn some of these qualities of, you know, communicating your ideas and thoughts. And when you are getting collaboration energies from the business and the technologist as part of your Skunkworks, your energies will grow. Get their help to also communicate your ideas. That way they learn your design principles and you get help in terms of communicating your ideas. Principle, respect people, dignity of work. Everyone in any ecosystem, whether you're providing a service or a product, are always striving their best. But still, things are broken. So start respecting, understanding the principle of human behavior and see how we can influence their lives. If we influence their lives, that means the design impact is growing up and there is a far better user experience. Being open-minded, caring, we don't need to talk much about it. We all are good in terms of our empathy. Risk takers. days go by when we are very busy in front of our user interfaces and creating wireframes, but we will have to shrug off that and take some additional risk and see, as a designer, what really I could do in the realm of creating a far more impact as designer. And a few other things. So those are the things that I feel could be the qualities that you could start imbibing. A way to do is take some of these slides and start understanding what does this really mean. Create a small workshop with the people that you feel that you could create a meaningful impact, and take it forward from there. And so when you now look from left to right, probably you will have a lot more energy to go beyond user interface and user experience of just the digital products, but go much more wider. And as a true designer and a true business impact agent, could do a meaningful job. That's my last slide. Thank you so much. So yeah, we could take some questions if you guys have it. Yeah, if you guys don't have questions, if you have any opinions, I'm open to opinions as well, or any feedback. If you did not understand any slide, I can always go back.
Question?
Yeah, please go.
So you highlighted the growth of design education in the country, right? Are you seeing that the design education curriculum is focusing on certain areas of your sort of design of things? Do you think that they're focused in the right areas? Do you think that, our educators need to be focused in the entire spectrum? Can you speak to that?
Oh, yeah. So in the last 3 years, we have started seeing design schools talking about user interfaces or user experience, because that's now a very focused area in this country. They have just started with user experience for user interfaces. The wider spectrum is yet to be touched upon, but I think that's a good idea. And some of these design school representatives could think about this and start doing it, because service design, system design thinking are the newer areas that we have to start looking, because if we can start bigger picture thinking, then user interface is just a small delivery that we can think of. So maybe that's where the high level thinking could happen right in the school. So yeah, thanks for asking that question. Yeah. Okay, well, if there are other feedback, opinions, questions, you can talk to me offline. Oh yeah, there's a hand there.
Hi, I'm Madhumita from Honeywell.
A little closer.
Okay. Hi. You spoke about technology business and design team working together. Do you foresee that these multidisciplinary team is part of one organization, or are you thinking that they are still in different parts of the organization and they come together for an initiative and then disperse?
Yeah, thank you. Good question. I was going to cover this as part of, you know, pods or squads that could have, but these are no formal teams. No one even knows what's happening. So it's not been identified in the organization. It's probably, you know, you who feel, hey, you know what, I need to do something about this area. And then you know Ramesh from another department who's taking care of that particular vertical, and you know Swati, who is probably a subject matter expert in that aspect. We three need to come together and do something. You come together and do something. Beyond your responsibility, of course, there's that challenge. But that's what you do. And there could be smaller pockets of these squads or pods that could keep working and showing some very high impact work, versus just a designer thinking and creating one slide or two. Now there is a business subject matter expertise and designers coming together and presenting a much more value to the management. And there could be a lot of these squads. The more these squads are, the more happy the business decision makers would be.
Hi, sir. How I can define myself right now is basically, I'm a resource, external resource, but I am assigned to a particular product. So I'm a designer that's assigned to a particular product, and we have obviously other designers assigned to other products. So the challenge here is I want to contribute more to my product than what it already is. But there are already like ongoing projects and interventions that we need to do that we just don't get, you know, the opportunity or the chance, but we want to interject in that way. How would we, you know, want to approach that?
So remember those few slides that I'd mentioned earlier? Yeah, these. So for whatever area that you feel you want to make an impact, do some of these fact findings with people who also would like to contribute to it. So if you're a designer, that's what I'm saying is, let's say you want to change the way the channel, distribution channel is. It's weak, it's not working well. You say, hey, okay, who's the channel executive? Talk to him. Talk to the subject matter expert in the same area. Maybe who's the technologist who's taking care of that stream? Talk to him or her, of course, and group together and see what are the broken pieces. And take that as a challenge and then do it. But of course, as I said, this is probably after 6 o'clock, because you may have a lot of work that you want to deliver, but somewhere we have to do that intervention. Otherwise, we'll be always doing 9 to 6, 9 to 6, years will go by, and nothing would be done. We'll be still creating what has been told. Remember the silos that I was talking about? Businesses have the ideas, they send it to technologists, and then the technologists send it to designers, mostly implementation work. Do we want to do that? So somewhere we'll have to be proactive enough to make our impact noticeable and make the creative impact. We will have to make some changes in the way we operate. Did that answer your question? Yeah, we are done. Thank you so much. Thank you.